very exciting day today. It's not every day you get a nice upgrade to your personal setup, but that looks like what is about to happen right here, because this is the biggest computer monitor I've ever seen. It's 43 inches. This is the latest from LG. It features an IPS 4K display, 10-bit color, remote control, multi-display setup within the monitor. This is so big now that you might want to have separate inputs for each of the four quadrants. It's also got stereo speakers built in, USB Type-C, which is important to me because I connect the latest MacBook Pro up to it, and hopefully it works well with this one like it is with the 38-inch ultra-wide that's sitting over there right now. This thing is massive. I mean, what other way is there to put it?
Jack, you definitely remember this. The biggest Swiss Army knife known to man. Look at that.
Some cables over here, it looks like. You've got... oh, and a remote control. It actually does have a game mode as well. Volume, brightness, check that baby out right there. An HDMI cable, a DisplayPort cable, a power cable, some cable management for the back of the display, a Type-C to old school USB adapter, some screws to mount it on the base, and some batteries for the remote control. Some paperwork. That's a big boy right there. Okay, on the back here, we have our various ports. There's a ton of ports on this thing. I see 1, 2, 3, 4 HDMI ports. Two of them are 4K 60p capable. The other two are 4K 30p capable. There's AC in for power. You have your display port in, USB Type-C, super speed, old school USB connector. It's also got a USB hub built in. There's also a headphone jack because audio is gonna be carried into here via HDMI. And if it's not going through the speakers that are built into the unit, it can go out the headphone jack. Look at that! That's something to behold. Holy smokes, that's huge! Look at that, that's nice though. Wow, the speakers are actually pretty good. Look at that, what? Look what Jack did to me! It sort of feels more like a TV than a monitor, especially when you consider the sound. Like, I just... listen to this.
It's a Chinese smartphone maker. One of the biggest there is, Meizu, and the phone is called the Pro 7 Plus. It features two displays.
So I feel like there might be some distortion here with the lens, but like, let me put my, you see what's going on there? You see what? That's huge. It's a huge display. Holy. So for video, for productivity, you know, like if I bring up, let's say a recent image, look at this. We're getting in there. It's unbelievable. The beard. We've talked about the beard in the past. Look at that.
That's where you find the winds of 185 miles an hour. But notice it has a second eye wall where you still will find intense winds, likely over 100 miles an hour.
Hello, I'm Cavassier, the goddamn newt. Sometimes I see things and I don't understand what I'm seeing.
So one of the coolest things about this monitor is the ability to set up picture in picture or like multiple pictures, multiple inputs at once. And if you go to the input area of the menu, there's something called PBP, PIP, and it'll let you use multiple inputs for a split screen horizontally, vertically, four different windows, and then the more classic picture in picture where you would have something else in the corner of the display. Oh, there it is. Look at that, and I moved it over there. This is a crazy one, this particular setup here, because this screen is big enough that you could be watching something up here, gaming over here. Maybe you have like, I don't know, maybe you're into the stock market or something, that could be over here. The weather could be over there. You could be enjoying four different things all at once. All right, so here's what I'm talking about. In the top left corner, I have Battlefield going on, but then over here, I have a YouTube video, and you know, you gotta catch up on your Unbox therapy even when you want a game, and so on. So you could pick whichever one you want audio to be coming from at any given time. I have them both muted right now for the purpose of this video, but you can move this thing around any corner you want, and it's multitasking. This is the future right here. No one wants to pay attention to only one thing at once. That's boring.
There we go. Oh, sweet.
So having this little bit of information, I guess, is kind of nice. You have the steps, the time, the weather, and so on.
You got your videos, you got your YouTube, you got your Netflix, you got your sports. You can do it all. Now, this is obviously not new. Picture in picture, you've seen it before, but I personally haven't used it on a monitor before. It's your TV, too. It's your entertainment hub. It can charge up your devices with those USB ports. It can be an actual hub. Then it has tons of HDMIs for all your various sources, even a cable box if you have one or if you want one. And then you can skip having a TV at all. You can just have this in your setup for both your computer monitor and your entertainment display. It's big enough and it's 4K. Plus it's IPS. Look at where I'm sitting right now. Off axis, I still see it perfectly fine. I don't know, I think it's pretty cool. I'm gonna put it on my desk and see how it plays out. It is huge, so as a computer monitor, I think I'm gonna have to sit back a little bit or maybe just push it back further on the desk. Shouldn't be an issue. 43 inches. I seriously didn't think I would see the day. Question time, which I can do on the big monitor because, well, it only makes sense, doesn't it? Okay, here's one from Midnight Savage. Out of everything you reviewed this month, what was the best thing and why? That's difficult to answer because generally if I'm featuring something on the show, it's because I like it, but something comes to mind here because it's sitting right in front of me, and that's this keyboard from Mionix. As you can see, I kind of customized it. I actually changed out some of the keys for other keycaps. This thing is nice. It's a lot quieter than my last mechanical keyboard. I like the look of it, and the keys are silky smooth, very soft touch plastic. So I'm using it. It's in my setup now. All right, here's one. What is your favorite phone in 2017? Well, obviously 2017 is not over, so I can't give a definitive answer, but I will say the device that is in my pocket and has been in my pocket is the Galaxy S8. I know a lot of people, they wonder, they're like, they watch these videos, they say a lot of things. They go, Lou's sponsored by Apple, he doesn't say what he's thinking, and so on. I actually made a video specifically about that point. But it's funny because like in the Note 8 video where I was critical of that device, it was in relationship to the S8. Like it wasn't enough for me to justify the difference in price versus what you get in the S8. So it's the S8 that's been in my pocket, and for now, is probably my favorite phone. That said, there's a bunch more that I have to put more hours into that might surpass this one. We'll see. 2017 isn't over yet. Here's one from Brian Cabrera. Hey Lou, you featured some sneakers in your past videos. If you could have only one pair of sneakers, what would you choose? He's right. I made a video with Brad Hall. It was too much fun.
Very excited to be here.
We unboxed every Air Jordan sneaker that came out during Michael Jordan's career. It was an insane video, but the thing is, I actually like a running shoe a little more than a basketball sneaker. I find them a little more versatile, a little more comfortable for day-to-day tasks. And speaking of sneakers, I just got some new ones. Check this guy out right here. This is the new 574 Sport. If you guys have been following me for a while, you know I've worn New Balance shoes. And this one is lighter, it's more modern. I'm enjoying this so far. I got this, what, yesterday? Maybe, look at that thing. It's got like this cool color to it. It comes in a couple of different colors, but super comfortable, and it's more in line with, you know, the Ultra Boost stuff from Adidas and whatnot. It's like, it's lightweight. I don't know if it's my favorite sneaker ever, but it's gotta be close. Okay, cool. Thanks to everyone for those questions coming in. Make sure on this video, you leave some fresh ones. Ask me about some tech. Ask me about upcoming devices or devices that I've featured right here. Let's do a follow-up. I want top quality questions down below, and who knows, you may end up in the next episode.